passage, there is a blessing to God through from our of our Lord Jesus Christ, who, according to his great mercy, has done what? His mercy, his grace, he has caused us to be born again. You cannot save yourself. Look at the person beside you. You cannot save yourself. Tell the other one. You cannot save yourself. God has to cause it. You can respond to the gospel, and you can realize you need Jesus, and you can pray and receive Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. But if you're going to be saved, it's because God is going to do that work. He's going to cause you to be born again. Now, this is not a hope that's just kind of a, oh, that's nice. This is a living hope. It's a living hope because Jesus is alive. He rose from the dead. And so now you and I can obtain this inheritance. Now, you know, on my father's side of the family, you know, the inheritance back in the day might have been, you know, the horse that was most recently stolen, or if a still was still working somewhere. That was just kind of, you know, the way it was in West Virginia, that part of my family. And you think, well, you know, what are my kids going to get as an inheritance in material things? You know, they're just hoping we'll go to eat Mexican food today. Amen, brother? All right. So here's the thing. What has God provided for us in Christ? An inheritance that cannot perish. You have to let these things soak in. If you don't ever read the Word, and you don't just ever let this soak in, you don't realize who you are. And you do not realize what you have. You're looking at your circumstances. This is, I look at my circumstances, and we forget who we are and what we have. We have been saved by God our Father through Lord Jesus Christ. We have, because of his resurrection, obtained an inheritance which cannot perish. It is not going to be defiled. It will not fade away. And it is reserved with your name on it. Guess where? In heaven. The only way for you to receive it is for you to go where? To heaven. And that's what God has arranged for you to do that. Now, as you go through this life, you can get so focused on, ooh, someday I can't wait. I'm going to get there and I'm going to have all this. But look what the scripture says to you and to me today. We are protected by the power of God. We are protected by the power of God. You say, well, what happened to Peter? I thought you said he was crucified upside down. And what happened to Paul? He had his head chopped off. What are you talking about? Protected by the power of God. One of these days, we are going to get used to the idea that this physical transportation is not us. This is not us. This is transportation for our physical world. And we think this physical transportation has to always be happy, feel good, be able to go do whatever it wants to do. It gets a little older, it starts creaking, it starts aching, that sort of thing, and we're thinking, what's going on? I'm not doing well. No, your physical transportation is getting older, but you, if you're a Christian, are growing in Christ. You're becoming more and more and more like Jesus. That's a pretty good trade. Don't you think that's a pretty good trade? Yeah. So the real you, or you're being protected by the power of God, and God is fully able to protect your transportation as long as he knows you need it. As long as he has a reason for you to get around, he's able to protect that transportation. But he is going to protect you. Is it going to be because you do so good, because you have so many works, because you're such a wonderful person? What does the passage say? Protected by the power of God through faith. Through trusting God. Just trusting him. Allowing him to be the one who is in control of your life and your experience. But notice that salvation is going to be revealed in a very special way in the last time with the return of the Lord. So today we understand strength through humility and faith. Those who are born again are protected by the power of God through faith. Now in verse 5, we're going to revisit a verse that we talked about last week. And I'm not picking on you younger guys. It's just, how can I get to the last half of the verse without the front, right? You younger men, likewise, be subject to your elders. And all of you, we just changed. And all of you. Who is all of you? Yeah, it's everybody that's here, plus everybody else who's in the body of Christ that's not here with us. All of you, clothe yourselves. Now, you know, we've talked about this before. In sanctification, we talk about the fact that you put off certain things from your life and you put on certain things in your life. So you put off pride and you put on humility toward one another. Why? Well, there's a benefit. Some people will look at that and say, oh, well, because God gets mad. No, I want you to understand this. Don't look at that and say God gets mad, for God is opposed to the proud. No, don't do that. Just don't do that. Look at the verse and understand that if you put on humility, you're going to experience more of the grace of God. The undeserved blessing and favor of God. If you just choose to put the pride aside and choose to humble yourself before God and not to be so self-focused. Humble toward one another, God is going to be able to give more grace in your situation. Therefore, for that reason, because of this, humble yourselves. And actually in the Greek, that phrase, humble yourselves, is would best be said, and we don't do this in English, but would say, allow yourselves to be humbled. Allow yourselves to be humbled under the mighty hand of God. In other words, don't resist it. God is going to work to create humility in our life. Why? What was Jesus like? He was humble. What are we supposed to be becoming like? Jesus. So he has to bring humility into our life for us to become like Jesus. It's unavoidable. And according to the scripture, this humility is going to bring strength in our life as we allow ourselves to be humbled under the mighty hand of God. That again sounds like,
under the mighty hand of God.
Like, uh-oh, I'm in trouble again. No, who is protecting us by faith? God is. And so where is this protection coming from? The hand of God. The mighty hand of God is on my life. He is protecting me as I trust him by faith to be in charge. And so as I humble myself before God, I come under his protection and his care. And as I am willing to humble myself, who ever talked about humbling yourself? You remember Jesus talking about this? He told some people one time, he said, look, if you go to an event and you put yourself way up at the head table and somebody more important than you comes in, what's going to happen? Oh, get up, please, and move down there. Oh, how embarrassing. But Jesus says, no, it would be better to sit down at the far end of the table. And as you're sitting down there for the host to come and say, what are you doing out here, brother? Come on up to the head table. Well, this is what God is talking about. He wants us to be willing to humble ourselves, to be and do whatever he wants. And at the right time, at the best time, he's going to exalt us. Now, what did we know about that time? You remember when we were receiving our inheritance and all that's going to be revealed back in the previous verses. It says that this would be revealed in the last time. In the last time. There's going to be a day when all of those people that you knew that picked on you at work, picked on you at school, said that you were, you know, goody two-shoes and all that kind of stuff. They're going to see you standing there in a resurrection body right beside Jesus. And whatever they thought about you in the past, they're going to see you exalted at the proper time. They're going to know God did that. You didn't do that. He has exalted you. He has done it. So, with all of these factors, what are we? We've got rid of this idea that God is going to crush us. Look what it says. Casting all your anxieties, another good word would be cares, on him. Because he cares for you. He is going to take your cares because he is caring for you. And so as you humble yourself, as you allow yourself to be a person who is trusting God, then God is able to take these anxieties and issues and things that you face, and He's able to help you along the way, help you to carry these things. Amen? Is that good? So let's look at strength through humility. We know those who are born again are protected by the power of God through faith, and also that those who are born again should be humble toward one another, because God gives grace to people who are humble toward one another, and that this faith and humility allows us to trust God with our cares. So what are you going to do with your cares and your anxieties and your burdens? I've got to come up with tuition. I've got to come up with transportation. I've got to come up with some kind of deal to handle this medical issue that I'm facing. Oh, really? Could God do that for you? Or are you presenting yourself to God humbly and trusting in Him to guide you and direct you in that? Yeah, but what if He doesn't do it right? How dare we? But we do it all the time. What if He doesn't do it right, Susan? Oh, I'm sorry. I thought He was God. And that He knows what's best for us in every situation. Well, in verse 8, it does focus on the fact that we are to be involved in this process by being sober in spirit. Be of sober spirit. In other words, you know, don't go through your life just oblivious to God and what He's doing, just flitting about from thing to thing. But, you know, get your head in the game. Get focused. Be on the alert. Be on the alert, you know, is one thing if you're, you know, you're saying, okay, I'm in the line on Black Friday and I'm trying to get one of those Xboxes and I've got to be alert for where they are and everything and look out for the lady with the pepper spray. I mean, you know, you kind of get that, right? You know, there's a lady in the place with pepper spray. Look out. But in this particular passage, we're being told that there's a much bigger situation. Be on the alert. You have an adversary. Someone is going to be working against whatever God is working on in your life. So whatever things that God is up to, the enemy is going to do as much as God will ever allow him to turn you away from that blessing. To get you to drop the humility, to be proud enough to think that you have the